The love of my life is doing research. As the first person in my family to go to college, my mentors, who ran research labs of their own, were critical to my getting to where I am today. And I want to provide the same sort of support for young scientists here at Rochester. There were no female faculty members when I was a graduate student. I think it's important for everyone to get mentoring. Compared to men, fewer women who earn a PhD degree go on and use that degree in a career. I'm very excited about RNA research. I'm the cheerleader for RNA research, and now I have a big audience because of the vaccine. I study RNA in the context of human disease. Many diseases are either inherited or acquired mutations in the DNA, the genetic material, but the mutation often manifests at the level of RNA. It might have seemed that these vaccines appeared overnight. And I have to say that if we had the pandemic a couple of years earlier, we wouldn't have been in the position that we were in when we needed to have vaccines develop quickly. But these vaccines have been under development from both the perspective of RNA biology and the nanoparticle biology for decades. RNA-based therapeutics have an amazing potential to treat a variety of inherited and acquired diseases. And the only way we're going to understand disease and treat it in a personalized medicine way, to tailor it to a particular person, is to understand what is going on at the molecular level in these patients, and that's where RNA biology kicks in. Philanthropy accelerates the rate at which we are able to work. It accelerates the rate at which we can make discoveries and follow them up. There is so much to learn, and one never understands the importance of what one is going to find until we start investigating. And that's the Rochester Effect.